November is Stomach Cancer Awareness Month, and many might not realize it's the third leading cause of cancer deaths in the United States. I'm joined here by Eileen, Laura, and John, who are from No Stomach for Cancer, an awareness group about the illness. Eileen, you're here because you lost your son to stomach cancer.
Yes. 5 years ago, he was 22 years old and a college athlete.
Wow. Can you tell me a little bit more about that? I mean, did it kind of just happen out of the blue?
He started with some symptoms in September, and the doctors just shrugged it off as indigestion, constipation, those types of things. When he came home at Thanksgiving, I said, no, you need to push doctors more. Mm-hmm. We got the diagnosis that it was stomach cancer on December 30th, and he passed away 6 weeks later in February.
Wow. Did you ever think that your young, healthy son would ever develop stomach cancer?
No, until it happened, I hadn't even really heard of stomach cancer. It's not one of those that makes the news. You hear so much about the other cancers, but this one is just kind of like the silent one, and it sneaks up, and it's devastating.
Mm-hmm. Now, Laura, you kind of have a different story. You have taken the preventative measure to prevent yourself from getting stomach cancer. Can you talk about that?
Sure. So my family, I know I have a grandpa and two aunts that passed away from stomach cancer, and so we knew a little bit ran in the family, if you will, but we found out when my aunt died in 2005 that my family is a carrier of a gene mutation called CDH1. And with this gene, it gives you over an 80% chance of getting stomach cancer in your lifetime. The tricky thing is, with other cancers like breast cancers and such, there's really good surveillance methods, mammograms, MRI. With this specific type of stomach cancer, it's called diffuse. It's kind of tricky. It kind of grows in the lining of the stomach and then diffuses out. So by the time that you're diagnosed, your five-year survival rate is about 5 to 10%. So what they recommend, if you test positive for the gene, which I did, and I have two cousins and an aunt, and my mother that also tested positive for the gene, they recommend that you have your stomach out prophylactically. So I went to Mayo Clinic in Rochester, had my stomach out, and still able to live. Wasn't an easy process, but and so that eliminates my risk. Mm-hmm. Doesn't eliminate the risk that my kids still face, right? So I have two kids, so that's part of why I joined the No Stomach for Cancer organization, to promote awareness for stomach cancer and funding for research, et cetera.
Right, you two are just two people out of hundreds of thousands impacted by this every year, and that's why you guys are raising awareness. And John, you guys are having a walk next weekend on November the 7th. Can you tell me about that and why it's important for people to come out and join the cause?
So this is our fourth annual worldwide walk, and in the past, people from all over the globe would organize walks on their own, and we would support them. This year is our first Madison area walk, and so it's very important not just for us in our backyard to raise awareness and funds for our research and our mission, but it's just important for people to get out, understand the importance of stomach cancer, and you know, get out and walk with us and help us raise awareness. So you know, they can email us directly at walk@nostomachforcancer.org, and I can provide them all the information they need to get involved.
All right, great. Thank you so much. And we'll have all that information on our website, nbc15.com. We'll be right back.